Hey there guys, welcome back to the channel. Just thought I'd do a full build guide on converting just a handful of cars, literally like three cars, and possibly some extra bits in your collection, but how to build a couple of drag racers. And to start off, you know, I have a bunch of these Carbonator cars. I was actually planning on, and I will do at some point, building some like floating cars using the engine that's inside the bottle. I'm not too sure if you've actually had a chance to take a look at that, what's inside there, but it's pretty cool. The other thing you're going to need is this the Diaper Dragger car. So you're going to need at least two, because you're going to be using the base, and then this other car here, this it's called the Head Starter. So according to the Gaslands rule book, you're going to be I think the drag cars have like a rocket booster on the back, but I just decided to build a couple of cars using the same base and just kind of see what I can come up with and try to make it easy enough that anyone can kind of replicate. So the first thing you're going to want to do is obviously go out and remove the rivets from the cars. If you haven't done this before, you need a drill in order to get the rivets out. There's other methods out there in terms of like heating up the rivets and just kind of melting the plastic, but this car actually has a metal base, and you can't really, but it's really easy. I mean, the body itself is plastic, and those are the easiest rivets to get out. So as you can see here, the engine just flew out right into the camera. But anyways, you're gonna need this part. Carbonator's engine is really good, and then you can use the front seat as well for your build if you choose to do so. There's a couple of ways of doing it in this build, so I kind of explored a couple of options, and truth be told, I actually needed another carbonator, and I thought I had a spare one that I had already taken apart, and I was going to use the seat from that. I just decided not to bother like opening up another package for this, so I kind of sourced my my bits box to find a replacement. Okay, so once you got all the parts, all the cars disassembled, you can just kind of lay everything out and just kind of plan your attack. So as you can see here, everything apart, you can kind of figure out like what your plan of action is going to be. So basically I was trying to figure out, okay, what can I easily just cut and mod quite easily between the two extra cars. So really you're going to need basically four models. You might want to just, build like one of these. But let me know what you think in the comment section down at the end of the video, down below, like which one you liked actually better, just in terms of overall appearance. And, if you use this idea and come up with your own, variation of it, I think it's kind of a neat idea. I just thought, I was going to use a different drag car model altogether, and then I noticed this Diaper Dragger base was like perfect, and I was originally buying them just to get the engine. So now there's a secondary use for them. Once you've actually bought them for the engine, you can maybe move, just use the chassis for something else. And I thought it would be appropriate to try to figure out how to build a cool looking drag car. So right now I'm just going to start by building, adding the engine blocks, to each model. And, I'll put some music on for a little bit and, kind of walk you through, how the build process went. And here it is all done. No, just kidding. This is actually going to be a car that I'm going to work on in the future. But here they are. Here's the two cars. And as you can see through the whole video, I decided not to narrate everything. But I finally got a chance to use the large makeup brush at the end to kind of just put some additional dusting on. And I thought it was kind of a neat idea versus using some of my other methods that I had before. But just to recap, the couple of cars that I use in the video, and I thought it would be good to just kind of show a before and after. When you put these cars together, you can kind of come up with really this one here. Like, you can buy this car with the diaper dragger and literally build this car yourself. Just using the two vehicles makes it nice and easy. You just have to chop with the Dremel tool is what I did. I basically just used the Dremel tool to cut the pieces that I need. And took a few tries to, trial and error to get it to fit just right. But, as you can see previously in the video, that I kind of had to split a few parts up, just kind of organize it. And then I used the hot glue gun to, put everything together nicely on the chassis. Once it was done, I just kind of built it up. What I would have done differently is maybe just different kind of coloration, but I thought it was, it kind of turned out pretty good. So you can use that seat that comes in the Carbonator on either model. It's up to you. I ended up finding another cockpit from another single, another car that I had in my bits box to use for a front seat, and kind of turned out very well. So you might have the same availability in terms of parts, but this is the diaper dragger, in case you not sure what it looks like. And if you buy that car, which is current with these other models, that should be on the shelf right now as the time of this video, you should be able to go out and build either one of these. I don't know, let me know in the comment section which ones you'd like better. Sort of like the green one on the left or the yellow one. I mean, they're kind of like the same color really now, but that was kind of the idea, was to, kind of have a variation of a build that can go in either direction using these, basically these parts cars. And, hopefully you guys liked the video. I'm planning on doing a death race car with this Mustang. I've got some parts on the way that I'm going to do like an unboxing video very soon, whenever that arrives. Who knows when, with the way the mail might be right now. I haven't really bought anything in ages, so we'll see what happens. But if you haven't liked or subscribed to the channel, please go ahead and do so, and stay safe, and hopefully you liked it, and thanks for stopping by.